Oh, hello there. Welcome to day 883 of What She Up To Now. Sharon Hornhouse from here, documenting my journey as I transition from the brick and mortar corporate world of business to the online world. It's been going on, I guess 2017 is when I decided to make the bold leap from the offline to the online world. And this is just sort of my daily journal documenting how it's been going. Now, 883 is less than 3 years, but I didn't start doing videos until probably 2018, after almost a year of people saying, you need to do videos, you need to do live videos, you need to get online, you need to put yourself out there, you need to document your journey. I finally started doing it, and I started, I thought, well, if I'm gonna do it, I might as well do it every day. And those of you who know me know I have vision challenges, so it's a lot easier for me to personally hop on to and record a video instead of trying to document and write out what I'm learning, what's working, what's not working, and what I'm actually doing to enhance and create my online presence and do things online instead of out in the world. And am I glad I did that? Heck yeah, with COVID-19 and all the craziness of 2020, I am so grateful that I decided to go online versus offline. So what does that mean for me? What the heck am I working on? What does mastery mean? Mastery means I am not there yet and probably never will be, right? With respect to online world and the way things are done online, because like most every business and industry I've ever been in, I push against the way things have always been done, or this is the way we do it. There are things about the online world that just rub me the wrong way. I mean, that I freaking hate. I hate the whole false scarcity and lack that is built up in the online world, just like the media focuses on the negative, the lack, the scarcity, to get people to take action. How manipulative is that? I mean, come on. So manipulative, so crazy what's going on in our world right now. The brainwashing and the techniques and the strategies that are being propagated on the American people right now, this whole election year, are freaking mind-blowing and really, really frustrating. There is an underlying current that is designed with intention, kind of like the old brainwashing in the Nazi days, and it's working. It's been working on the American people for over a decade now, and they have just gotten better at it. And it's not for our best interest, it's for the people that want the power's best interest. And until we wake up and smell the coffee and think for ourselves, it's really, really a frightening thing to watch. As I say, smell the coffee. So we need to become masters of our own life and not play the game the way other people want to use us as pawns, but to think for ourselves and to be ourselves and to continue to be the best version of ourselves that we can be. And that means all of us treating one another with dignity and respect and like we want to be treated. There, that's my golden rule again. I have found that in 2020, I've talked about the golden rule more than I have probably in the previous 59 years of my life. I turned 60 this year, so I mean, I've talked about the golden rule and how we treat other people, but never since 2020 have I found myself referring back to it, probably since kindergarten's the last time I thought about the golden rule this much, and how we treat other people and how we show up in the world. So mastery is of course, the counteraction to fear and to victimhood. And it's interesting to watch, but not in a good way, how many people, how many organizations are playing the victim card and jumping on the bandwagon of everyone's a victim and needs to be saved. Guess what? We all feel like victims sometimes, but none of us are really victims. And I've been a victim. I mean, I've been the victim of a lot of bad things that have happened, things outside of me, but I've never chosen to stay and be a victim. So I never think of myself as a victim, even though I have been victimized many times in my life and in my past. But it's kind of like any other negative thing that happens, any other negative emotion, we're all gonna experience them because we're human beings. We experience all of the spectrum of human emotion, but we don't have to choose to live there. I don't have to choose to live in fear and anxiety and doubt and worry and scarcity and lack. I can choose, but I might have a pretty miserable life. I choose to live in possibility. And I invite everybody to master that and do the same. I mean, it's interesting, there's this emotional guidance scale, and I talked about it, I think, day before yesterday as part of the Get Up and Go 40-Day Challenge. And there's 22 different levels of energy that are supposedly and are created by our emotions. So if I'm feeling love, I'm feeling a really high frequency moving energy. We can sense people's energy even before we meet them or experience them personally. When somebody walks in the room, have you ever been in a room? Somebody walks in the room and the energy of the room just goes up because that person lights up the room. We've all experienced a person like that. And then another person will walk in the room and it's just like there's a little dark cloud around them and they just are exuding this negative energy. Maybe they're angry about something. They just had a fight with their significant other or something, but you can just feel it coming off of them in waves. I noticed this. I used to, whenever I would go for a walk, I would like to observe people. And it was interesting that just when I was walking by somebody I'd never met before, you can tell if they're and it's just an instant snapshot. Are they in a good, positive mood right now, or are they in a negative mood right now? Because you can tell by their facial expression, the way they walk, their posture, and the energy that comes off of them. So I don't remember why I said, frequency and energy. And it's interesting to me that there's only 7 of those levels that apply to positive vibrations and positive high frequency emotions. And contentment is 7, and I guess you could argue contentment is a pretty low level positive emotion, right? If I'm just satisfied and content and everything's just hunky-dory, fine, okay. It's more like being okay to me. Everything is okay. And then all the ones below that, 8 to 22, and there's more than one in each emotion in each category. It depends how we describe and define things. But all of those are negative. Have you ever gone through a dictionary or looked at a book of words? It's like the same proportion of negativity and negative terms and negative words and negative words to describe things versus positive. Well, guess what? Our language and our words have power. They have creative power in our lives. And if we're using and thinking and feeling negative things all the time, what are we creating in our life? And there's so much of that going on in our country right now. It's really, it's pathetic because it's being purposefully propagated and created to control the masses, to make us all feel like we're victims and we need our politicians to save us. What a crock, right? I guess I'm getting opinionated, I better stop. I just believe that each and every one of us are amazing human beings and we have the power to create the life that we love and want. Every one of us, all of us. And so for a certain group of people to say, we know better than you, we're superior, we're gonna tell you how to think, how to feel, what you need to do, because really, we know you're too stupid to figure it out yourself. We know you're too stupid to make your own decisions. I find that so offensive that I can't even fathom it. It's mind-blowing to me that anybody would want to be, I guess it's be sheep. We're sheep when we're being victims. And we're sheep when we're letting other people think and control us and do things for us because they know better. You know, I mean, it's kind of the definition of politician, right? Okay. That's how I really feel about politics. I feel that it's about control and power and money and greed and all those things that should make us really upset and sick to our stomach. I mean, it's one of those, well, we don't know what we don't know kind of situations, and we can't believe, you know, but I remember back when I was a kid, you could actually believe the media. You could believe and trust the messages that were being delivered to you because they weren't editorials or opinions or propaganda, which, you know, it reminds me of the old films they used to show from the World War times and the Depression era and things when it was all designed to manipulate and control and work people up into a frenzy. I mean, these are military strategies that are being deployed on the American people that in my thoughts are treasonous and to destroy us by getting us to fight against one another and harm one another. And then, you know, our politicians are just gonna come in and save us. They're gonna save us all from ourselves. Well, guess what? They're the ones creating the drama and the trauma and the infighting and the separation because they want us to be victims. Because if we're victims, then we need them to save us. Really, really sick cycle of events going on. And again, just watching it from the outside and watching it unfold in actual horror and dismay, because I know we're better than this. We as a people and a country are so freaking powerful, and how we have let political parties and politicians and people with money and greed and ulterior motives take over us and control us, it's pretty mind-boggling. Anyway, what else am I working on besides being ignoring what's going on in the world that's negative and so effed up? Get Up and Go Challenge, day 29 today already. 40-day free challenge to help people get exactly what they want in one of the key areas of their life, or all of the key areas of your life. As I'm going through the 40-day challenge, I'm working a little bit. I'm going through the SOAP framework for physical, mental, emotional, spiritual, relationships and contribution, and what am I, financial. Why do I always forget financial? Financial, through each of those seven areas of my life. And I've been through, I'm on my fifth one already. I'm working through emotional, which is, you know, kind of a push for me. Relationships, emotional, mental, and then spiritual we'll do next week. Those are hard to share. Those are hard things to share with people because they're so personal to each and every one of us. But part of why I'm sharing is because I want people to know that you do the work and you don't have to tell anybody. You definitely don't have to tell anyone else what you're working on or thinking about or creating in your own life. You just do it for yourself. But I want to be an example and say, okay, yeah, this is hard for me too, but I'm going to share it so that you know it's hard for me too, but it doesn't mean that we don't do it. Just because it's hard doesn't mean we shouldn't do it. Fun challenge. I'm doing a 365-day challenge to do one fun thing every day. So glad. I think this every day, how grateful I am that I decided that 2020 should be the year of fun. Because normally I hang out with my, actually she's five now, my granddaughter turned five. And I hang out with her every day, especially since COVID and life has been happening to each and every one of us so that her folks can continue to build their lives and they can work and do the things that they need to do. I get the pleasure and I swear she has saved me personally through this pandemic, through all the craziness that's going on in the world, because I get to focus on the young, excited energy and creativity and amazingness that children have. And it's so much about love and empowering and discovery and curiosity that it's just a joy to be around. So I'm glad I picked fun because it reminds me that there is something fun that we can do each and every day. And we have a ton of fun. We don't just do one fun thing, we do a lot. But I like to use the little journal book, Do One Fun Thing Every Day, as just a guide of, hey, if I don't have an idea of something fun, what would be fun about this? And today's was all about the secret garden, which is so funny because just the other day, she and I were talking and she wanted to watch The Secret Garden because my sister was talking about it and they were doing some weed pulling and gardening. And so now she was all excited about, you know, I've talked to her and tried to get her to watch The Secret Garden the whole time. And now that it's not available on Netflix or streaming TV and I haven't been able to find it yet, I'll have to look some more. I didn't look over the weekend. I'm up at the cabin. I'll have to find it so she can watch it because I think she'd be delighted by it. I think she would love it. So that's funny that today's challenge was from The Secret Garden for the fun, do one fun thing every day. So my challenge is once I get home from the cabin to find a copy of The Secret Garden. Now it's funny because when I moved, I had that on a disc, a CD. I had tons of movies, I mean thousands of movies. Before streaming video, I used to buy movies for the kids all the time to keep them entertained because I canceled television on them and they didn't like that. They didn't like that we got rid of the Disney Channel. So working on that, working with a brand new group, which I do actually have, I don't remember if we have an accountability meeting or a mastermind meeting this week, but I'm doing a couple of projects for that, and I've been pretty lax on it this last week. Summer, beautiful weather, I'm not making excuses, I'm just saying I haven't done it yet. I'll get it done though. I always get it done before our deadlines. So working on that. I have done part of it, but I don't have the whole thing done. There's always pieces, right? Life is a continually improving process, and there's always pieces that we're working on, and I am no exception. So working on that. That's it. That's all I've got for today. If I can help you in any way, shape, or form, ask in the comments below. Again, if I don't know the answer, I will tell you I don't know the answer, but this is what I would do next, or this is a person or a resource or a tool or something that could really help you in this situation. Because guess what? We always know what to do. Even if we think we don't know, we do know. And sometimes we just need somebody to tell us, yep, that's your next thing. Go do it. You know, sometimes we feel like we need someone else's outside of us permission to give us permission to go and create what it is we want to create or what it is the next step that we need to do. All right. Have an absolutely awesome day. And I will, of course, be with you tomorrow.